Giants. Our mythologies are full of giants, no matter which culture or religion or race you belong to. Either you are European or Indian or American, giants are the part of your folklore. They were the part of fairy tales and nightmares, from being heroes to villains in the stories. In history, many archaeologists have claimed that they have found the skull and skeleton of huge giants, but they were seldom taken seriously. So is it really possible that these strong giants once ruled the earth? Or they were just made up by our ancestors to explain the unexplainable? Or the ancient authors personified evil as giants to give society a moral story? So what is it? Want to know? If you just said yes, then keep watching this video till the end and we are going to dig deeper and we'll find out the answers. Ancient texts and stories talk about tall, big and strong creatures who held the heaven and once walked on earth. These creatures were giants who represented the force of chaos. So what exactly these stories are? And why is it that we believe that these huge creatures once existed? Remember Thor, the god of thunder? Legends talk about the fiercely frost giants who once fought battle with Thor along with other gods. They were so strong that ultimately father of Thor, Odin, had to intervene, and it was only his wisdom who made them surrender and sent them into darkness. And not just giants, even gods like Zeus, Hercules and Atlas are described as big and huge. Similar to that, if we look into India, giants were a huge part of Indian culture and their mythological stories. It is said that these giants used to reside in Patal Lok, which is a city inside earth. Time to time they came on surface for their food and to claim the world, but all the times they were defeated by gods and were sent back to the dark city. In Indian mythology, there is an epic Ramayana. In Ramayana, they talk about different giants walking in the forest. The most famous among all was Kumbhakarna, a warrior with a gigantic size and great appetite. The other epic Mahabharata, which is the world's largest epic, also mentioned giants in its stories. In its multiple stories, the protagonist Krishna, who was actually the god, had been shown fighting giants in his childhood. And it's not that giants are only in the stories of gods, but if we turn the pages and look into the medieval times, we'll be amazed to see how these giants have modeled the culture of a complete nation. The British Isles have hundreds of references to giant kind being both friend and foe. And how is it possible that we are talking about giants and British Isles and we don't talk about Stonehenge? One of the world's most famous prehistoric monument, which consists of huge standing stones, have multiple theories about its creation. Some stories claim that these structures were built by Merlin, the magician, while other stories say it was British King Vortigern who, after defeating the race of English giants, dispatched them to Ireland to retrieve a group of special stones. So these giants carried the stones back to British, and these structures were made as a marker for the brave soldiers who died fighting the giants. Another story of England's huge giant kind is about an invader Danish giant who came across the sea and was later killed by the locals living there. The locals made an enormous chalk outline to warn other giants to stay away from the land. They also carved a 180-foot giant on the surface. The fun part is you can still see these linings and the giant and its best seen from the sky. Not just these, there are hundreds of other stories like the giant of St. Agnes and structures like the Giant's Causeway, the giant hills of Kesal and the gigantic stone construction of Baalbek, Lebanon, which make you think about the existence of giants. We don't have much explanations that how and why these structures were built. How humans at that time without any advanced technologies were able to move such huge structures. Also, there have been many archaeological findings like one published in a newspaper in 1882. According to the article, a skull of heroic size and singular formation was discovered among the relics in the river valley. With it, multiple skeletons of men, women and animals were also found near it. Also, there was a newspaper called San Antonio Express, which published about a giant skull unearthed by WPA workers near Victoria. So maybe there was an older race in a time before time, when Earth was populated by the giants, and when we human came, we had to do battles to find our own place in the world. But wait, why should we look at it with just one perspective? There could be another side to these stories. Maybe giants never existed and they were just made up to frighten the children or to preach some moral values. Here is one story of Goliath, a 9 feet tall Philistine warrior. Each day, Goliath used to come to the river and challenge Israeli army to send their champion to fight with him. Just one day, a shepherd boy David, with one throw of his sling, killed that cruel giant warrior. Yes, that warrior was huge and tall and was thus portrayed as a giant. And maybe the author has done it intentionally to teach a moral lesson that it's not important that how big you are outside, but the important is how big you are inside. And maybe many of the ancient stories are written for the same purpose. I've seen people with heights more than 7 to 8 feet, like Robert Wadlow, who was nicknamed as Gentle Giant. No doubt, they look frightful and possibly our ancestors looked at them as evil. And not only these stories, but even religious institutions like church during medieval times used giant stories to deliver their messages and to prove how the virtue of Christianity have defeated the evil of the world. This was obviously done intentionally to prove the superiority of the Christianity. Also, we have seen how the ancient kings were assumed as the figure of giants and superhumans. This could have been done to showcase the divinity of the kings. If we look to the stories, most of the giants are just the personification of the evil, and thus, this makes the world suspicious about the existence of the giants. But even if these points seem valid, still we can't explain the giant structures that are found on Earth's surface, though some of them are explained as the result of volcanic eruptions like the Giant's Causeway. But there are many structures like Stonehenge and pyramids which are still mysteries for the humankind. So what's the truth? It's not always possible for us to reach to a conclusion. Sometimes the truth is hidden somewhere in between and we keep looking it on the extremes. So I will leave this for you to decide and I'll keep searching the other sides of the giant stories. Because believe me or not, the real fun is in looking for these stuffs. I hope you loved this video and if you did, don't forget to like and share this video and do subscribe to this channel. We are going to see you in your next video. Goodbye.